Hi guys, Sherry here from the Fox Given Crew. How's it going? So this is going to be a twin flame reading for March the 18th until the 25th, 2017. So instead of the regular twin flame reading, I like mixing things up a little bit. So this time I'm going to do a divine partnership reading. So that entails 9 cards for the feminine, 9 for the masculine. And I will be doing an extended version, so I'll be pulling 3 confirmation cards for each position. And I will also be pulling 2 messages from the universe. So that'll give us an idea of what's going on in the 3D as well as the 5D. Alright, I think that's good enough. I've already shuffled these cards pretty good. But I'll give my deck a quick shuffle. I'll be using these for clarification. Stop. And I may be using the Osho Tarot for confirmation as well, if I need further messages. Okay, so for the masculine, how he views the relationship. 2 of Wands. Waiting game. So the Ace of Wands is that spark of divinity. It's that inspiration. It is seeing your highest visions and highest dreams and moving towards that. The 2 of Wands is making a decision in the past that wasn't based on fear. It was based on your highest destiny, your highest calling, your higher purpose. And, you know, making that decision to move forward, and now you're in a sense of waiting for that return. But while you're doing that, you're reevaluating your past and seeing where changes can be made in order to be successful, move forward. So 3 cards. 10 of Pentacles. The Knight of Pentacles. And the 6 of Swords. 10 of Pentacles is a completion. It is that arrival, that final resting place. Working and building up a wealth and then retiring. But importance is not based on what you've accumulated in the material world. It is how you live your life. Living your true, authentic life and having people around you that love you. Family is important. So there's a sense that he knows what his destiny is, his highest goals, his highest vision is this 10 of Pentacles, this sense of peace and completion. And then we got the Knight of Pentacles, my favorite knight. He is the most reliable knight. He will cross that finish line. He's loyal, dependable, and successful, the most successful knight, because every step has been measured. He's walking a tight wire rope, and so every step is calculated and balanced, and it's a movement forward. There's no turning back. And when this knight shows, it means that he's almost arriving at his destination. And what is his destination? It's this 10 of Pentacles. It's a sense of completion and arrival in the 3D world. It has to do with your highest vision. The 6 of Swords is finally deciding to move on from negative people, negative energy, and find your inner truth. It's moving from calm or choppy waters to calm waters. It is a calming of the mind. It's finding stillness and peace in the mind. And it's a decision has been made to live this life instead of this life. So, it represents a balance. The 2 of Wands is a decision. Either I can live this way or I can live, this way, darkness or light. So the decision was made to go towards the light. So when he looks at this relationship, he sees this happy ending, and he's making steps in order to move towards that, and it will end with a final release. Okay, so how do you view the relationship? Balance, justice card, number 11. So there's a two there, two ones, and then here's an 11, reduces to a two. So two is about a decision, or it has to do with balance, union. The justice card is karma coming back to you in a good way. But what I'm seeing here is that you are currently in the state of optimum balance, like you are the fulcrum of truth and justice and balance. And yeah, let's see what else. Knight of Wands, the Wheel of Fortune, and the Two of Pentacles. Okay, so the Knight of Wands, this is a forward-directed, fast, heated energy towards your goal, your highest vision, your dreams. And there's no stopping you. There's no stopping fire. It is forward. So this could represent a fire sign. The pentacle could represent an earth sign. So there's a sense that there's a significant change going on. And it requires a state of balance, optimum balance. Wheel of Fortune talks about that change as well. And being in a state of balance while this major significant change happens, it is a release, a surrender to the winds of change. It represents a cycle of completion, so about 5 to 10 years. But it is an ending and a beginning. So there's a sense that there's an ending taking place and a beginning soon. So the wheel of change is spinning, and it's spinning in your direction. Good fortune is coming towards you, good luck, and karma, double whammy of karma coming back to you in a good way. Then we have the Two of Pentacles, and this is also about change. It's a decision that's made about the 3D world. So the only thing that's certain is change. And there's a sense of feeling unsteady as this wheel is turning. But you are ultimately holding balance while this change occurs. So even though you feel like you want to move forward towards your destiny, towards your goal, your destiny is actually coming towards you. The Wheel of Fortune is destiny. So all you need to do is just maintain your balance and be flexible, bend with the wind. The Knight is a forward momentum. Same with the Knight of Pentacles there. It's both forward, a decision to move forward. Sorry, they don't want to stay up for me. Okay, so what is he resisting? The sun, light. This is the best major arcana to have. This is abundance coming in. It is a brand new beginning. It is a rebirth. Seeing the world through a child's eyes. It is playfulness, innocence, purity, but it is your time to shine in the light. So he's resisting this. He's resisting reaching for the stars. He's resisting stepping into his fullest potential, fullest illumination. The Magician, Seven of Swords, and Four of Cups. Okay, so the Magician is about manifesting your dreams into reality. It is creating your own reality. So there's a sense that he wants to start something new, to really ground something in the 3D, make it happen. But then there's this Seven of Swords here, and this is deception and envy. There's a sense that somebody is deceiving him, or he doesn't trust somebody in his environment. He wants this completion, this happy, you know, Sun card, and he wants a new beginning, but he can't. There's a sense that he feels like he's in a holding pattern, like there's stagnation. Things aren't moving fast enough. And it's because he's holding on to this negative energy here. I'm pretty sure he got it last week as well. And yeah, he still needs to cut that away, release it. But again, you know, there's a sense that he is making that decision to do that. And it's almost like, you know, it's a confirmation that it's time to move into the light. But there's that still that sense of resistance. Okay, so what are you resisting? Or not you, I'm sorry. What is the feminine resisting? The Four of Cups. Repeated card. So we got the Four of Cups here in his resisting position. So it's coming up as a main energy. So again, it's a sense of discontent and boredom. It is stagnation. Things aren't moving fast enough. Or somebody's not taking your cup of love. But there's a turning to the darkness. A focus on the darkness instead of the light. The Moon. The Queen of Wands. And the Ace of Swords. Sorry, there's a backdraft in my room and it pushes all the cards forward. Okay, so the Moon is, you know, there's a need for illumination. There's only half truth being spoken. The sense that things are not known. And you know, the card is asking you to go within, use your intuition to guide you out of the darkness and into the light. So there's a intuitive or psychic quality to this card. It is also, you know, diving into the subconscious and really seeking answers from within. This is also, you know, facing your shadow aspect, facing your fears head on in order to move through this dark veil. So there's a sense that you're resisting seeing the bright side. And then here we have the Queen of Wands. And this, she is a fire energy. She is the sun. She is the center of attention. She is beautiful, gorgeous. You know, people love to be around her. They're attracted to her, her energy, her fire, her passion. And then we have the Ace of Swords. So this is truth. She's naked, exposed. So there's a sense that she is exposing her deepest truths. The Sword suit is about communication. So it could be her wanting to speak her truth, or sense that she knows what she wants to do. She knows. She has made a decision, or is resisting making a decision, because of this, you know, darkness. This card also talks about cutting away darkness and barriers. So yeah, interesting combination there. Okay, so the message from the masculine's higher self. Wow, spiritual union, Two of Cups. His higher self is telling him to, you know, accept love into his life, that his twin flame is his true reflection, and that is where he feels most connected spiritually and you know, is where he's most loved. So, yeah, let me pull three cards for that. The Tower. The Nine of Wands. And the Ace of Cups. Okay, so in order for this union to come in, there needs to be something released. This is the Tower card, which means that something is coming down. A falsehood, a lie. Anything built on a faulty foundation was meant to come down. So it is the death of the old self, the ego. And with that destruction comes the rebirth, a new, you know, awakening. Then we got the Nine of Wands. This is being in the eye of the storm. It is fighting for what you truly want, standing in your power. But it also talks about being a wounded warrior as well. You know, you got a lot of wounds and battle scars, but you still have enough power within you and strength to fight for what you truly want and allow that tower to fall, because once it does, then we got the Ace of Cups. And this talks about only when you have let go of the past, forgiven yourself and others, and truly open your heart to allow love in, that's when abundance of love will come your way, this new start. So there's a sense that he knows in order to achieve this happy spiritual union, a tower must come down, but it is going to require a great deal of spiritual strength in order to get him through. It is super annoying that these keep falling down, sorry. Day. Okay, so message for the feminine higher self. Three of Swords. So she's currently experiencing some heartbreak and loss. Again, there's a sense of her being exposed. Her heart is open. She's standing there. Yeah. A lot of grief I'm sensing. Four of Swords, King of Pentacles, and the Hangman. So Four of Swords talks about, you know, moving away from negative people, negative thoughts, energy, and finding peace. It's solitude, rest, rejuvenation. It's healing of the heart, the broken heart. So if you haven't already, Spirit is asking you to withdraw and heal your heart. There's some things that need to be released. Then the King of Pentacles is the masculine energy in the 3D. He also represents harvest, abundance, achievement, being at a point where you don't have to worry about money anymore. Then we have the Hangman, which is surrender, letting go of control, seeing things in a different perspective. So, what I'm kind of getting here is, you know, there's a masculine energy here that is actually the one that is kind of finding rest and solitude and peace. And it has, then we got another masculine energy right beside it, which is, I'm almost sensing that he is withdrawing in order to heal himself. This Four of Swords talks about needing to make a decision about a foundation, about laying, having a start in the 3D world. So there's a sense that he's retreating in order to ground himself and come forward in the 3D. But it's creating this heartache and loss. And Spirit is asking you to surrender. This is another feminine energy. It's like a release. It's healing. It's the dark night of the soul. It is letting go of the pain. And this also talks about significant changes going on in your environment and just allowing those changes to happen without any direct influence from you. Just allowing it to be. Okay. Sorry about that. Okay. So for... I'm sorry. I'm so super OCD sometimes. There we go. Stay. Okay. So for the recent past position, the masculine, nice. Nine of Pentacles, harvest, completion of a cycle. It is feeling of, you know, feeling stable in the 3D world, that you've accomplished a lot. And this is ripeness. The fruit is ripe. It's falling from the branches. So he really feels like he has something to offer the feminine in the 3D, according to this card. Two of Swords, Eight of Cups, and Page of Cups. So the Two of Swords talks about making a decision. There's two important choices to make, and you don't know which way to choose. So it is causing a stall, a delay, inability to move forward. And it's a self-inflicted stop, because, you know, ultimately, you know, just making that decision will free you up, but you're kind of holding back on making that decision. You're weighing your options. Then we got the Eight of Cups, which is that decision is made to move away from negative emotions, negative people that are draining your energy, and then going off on a pilgrimage and finding your true higher calling, yourself, your higher purpose. And so, yeah, there's that decision is made, and off he goes on his little spiritual quest. Okay, so then we got the Page of Cups, and this is a brand new beginning of love. It's expressing yourself and your emotions to the one you love. But it is a longing, a wanting of a relationship to start, and there is a sense of a new beginning, but it's more of a communication. It is a beginning of love. So there's a sense that, you know, he feels that he's reached the completion of a major stage where he is opening himself not only emotionally, but also materially in the 3D world. He feels stable. He made a decision to move forward, follow his heart, express his love, and enjoy the finer things in life. Yeah, so there's a sense of ripeness. Look what I have achieved. And I desire to move forward towards my, you know, where my heart will take me. Okay, for the feminine recent past, shadow, moon again. So I'm sensing that the feminine is going through a dark time right now. She was releasing some fears in her recent past and is still resisting releasing more fears, and it's causing her heartbreak. So in the past, you've faced your shadow aspects, your fears, but it's still lingering. Nine of Swords. Now, the one and the eight reduced to nine, and you got a nine here. Another nine. So this is a completion. Then we got the High Priest. That's beautiful. Oh wow! And the Queen, Divine Feminine Twin Flame. That is so beautiful. Okay, so Nine of Swords is a completion. This is staying up at night, being consumed with thought, anxieties and fears, guilt, being plagued, inability to sleep, nightmares, and it's a self-imposed prison. So like I said, it's an ending. It is walking away from that. It is finally, you know, moving on out of the darkness into the light. Then we got the High Priest. This is a divine masculine in a spiritual form popping into the reading saying, even though I'm not with you in the 3D, I'm with you always in the 5D. So there's that connection there. It's a reassurance. And then we have the Divine Feminine Twin Flame, who has been reborn out of the darkness into her authentic, you know, divine form. So, yeah, this is a beautiful energy of I'm with you in the dark. Even though you may feel alone, I'm always there with you. The moon also represents a feminine energy. So here we got the sun, and then here we got the moon. And she got the moon twice. So, you know, that could just represent the feminine energy. And there's that intuitive and, you know, psychic ability that comes along with the moon. And here we got the high priest who has the crown chakra open and activated. So there's like a, you know, a channel that's formed between the feminine and masculine here. Okay, so the masculine's present, eight of pentacles. Positive movement forward. It is feeling, you know, a lot of achievement, success, and grounded. And it's movement towards the sun. It is harvest being assured and continuing to work and building on that. So he can achieve that ten of pentacles that he got in how he views love and relationships. So right now, there's a lot of pentacle energy here. So I'm going to pull three cards for that. Three of cups, the justice card, and the nine of cups. How beautiful. Three of cups is a union card in that, you know, two people have fallen in love and they come together to form a third energy, which is love. And it's a celebration of love. Feeling love moving through you, unconditional love, true love, and being open to receiving that love and sharing that love. It's a give and a take energy. Then we got the justice card again. So the feminine got this in her, how she views the relationship. So there's a sense that he's coming into balance. He is the fulcrum. He is, you know, karma's on his side. Justice will be served because he's decided to move forward towards his ultimate destiny, his happy ending. And then we got the Nine of Cups, which is wish granted. It is emotional satisfaction and bliss on a massive scale. So it's kind of a similar energy in that, you know, you're coming together to celebrate love. It's an arrival, another nine. You know, they're reaching the state of not having to worry about people manipulating you on an emotional level, enjoying the finer things in life like music, dancing, just fun, being around you. And that kind of is reflected with the Nine of Pentacles as well. It's just enjoying life, walking on the beach, going on a vacation, traveling, looking after yourself, and being open to sharing love with other people. Beautiful balance right in the middle here. So there's a sense that his heart chakra is wide open and he wants to move forward and make that ten pentacles happen. All right, so the feminine present, nice, eight of wands. This could represent communication coming in. It's accelerated motion, so it's energy coming towards her. She's made a wish on a star. She's reached for her highest goals and visions and dreams. And she sent out these seeds of intention, and now those seeds of intention are coming back to her in an accelerated rate. So her dreams are within reach. All she needs to do is reach out and meet it halfway. So this also talks about Cupid's arrows. So love coming towards her. Nice. Universe. Two of wands. And wow, another wish granted card. That is so beautiful. So the universe card, that's the completion of the fool's journey. you've gone through every stage of the fool's journey, from, you know, having a new beginning, feeling, you know, experiencing heartache and loss, and, you know, releasing yourself from mental prisons, establishing yourself in the 3D world, you know, and coming into this grand awakening consciousness, being really connected to the divine and to your divinity, really stepping into your true authentic self, going, you know, shooting for the stars. Absolutely beautiful. And here is, you know, that final piece of the puzzle is being put in place. And then we have the Two of Wands again. So the masculine got that in how you've used love and relationship. So again, there's this, you know, mirroring feeling that you're waiting for that return as well. The decision was made to reach for the stars, reach for your highest goals, expand your mind, see the horizon, and realize that you are actually connected to the universe. When you look out at the universe, you're looking back at yourself. And here the universe is right beside you. You are the star in the sky. I love all this expansive imagery here. You know, it's all looking at the universe. Every card is the universe is right beside you and recognizing you as a star. One moment. So yeah, it's like your wishes are going to be, you know, fulfilled. The door is open and you're waiting for that moment for, you know, your dreams to walk through. So the star card, this is wish granted. It is, you know, wishing on a star and having it manifest. This is also, you know, offering you hope and saying that you've been through the worst already. And now it's time to rest and heal your heart. That beautiful ending and energy is coming towards you in every single card. And you deserve it. That is so beautiful. I've never had that combination show up before. All of them have the universe. Okay, so for the masculine final outcome, nice. Divine masculine twin flame. He steps into his authority, into his ultimate power, into his authenticity. Nice. 11-11 calling card. Six of Pentacles and Eight of Pentacles. Okay, so this is a confirmation of a twin flame union. It's not in the cards for everybody. This is just a confirmation that he is aware of this connection on, you know, a deep level. He wants this union, this new start, this spiritual connection, and there's a sense that he's moving towards that in the 3D, making it a 3D reality. And I'm saying that because we got the Six of Pentacles here, which is about being open to giving and receiving in the 3D. It is having financial abundance, and so you are priming that pump of gratitude. You know, what you get out, or what you put out, you get back. And so there's a sense that he wants to share his material 3D world, physical world, with his twin flame. And that will come to fruition for some, not all. It is a general reading. Okay, so the Eight of Pentacles talks about working hard. It is this card repeated. So it's a sense that there's still this movement forward towards his ultimate goal of 10 of Cups, but he's feeling successful, very grounded energy here. And that's what the Divine Masculine, the Emperor, is, a grounded energy. It is a firm foundation laid. It is success and continuing to move forward towards that twin flame union. All right, so for the feminine future, I should just leave well enough alone. All right, nice. Nine of Wands. So where did I see this card? Okay, yeah, it showed up under the message from the higher self for the masculine. There's a sense of a wounded warrior here, along with the Tower card and that Ace of Cups. So because this is coming up in on the feminine side, there's a sense that, you know, that wounded warrior energy might be coming from the feminine, but I mean, I don't know. There's a beautiful image here of a Buddha who is using their spiritual strength in order to ground themselves in the spiritual. You know, there's this deep underlying courage and strength that the Buddha taps into in order to stand in his knowing. He is unwavering. It's a green energy, so it's love. And it's a nine again. There's a real sense of things coming to completion here. Major cycle ending. So this is a message not to give up, that, you know, give it that one last push. Sun card again. Hermit, another nine. And the Queen of Pentacles. Okay, so the best major arcana to have. So there's a sense that he stops resisting. What cards did he get with that? Shoot. Oh, yes. So he, with the sun, he got... I was just noticing the nine and the one reduces to one, and then he got a one here, so it's an 11, the magician. So he had the magician wanting to manifest, feeling like he can't trust, doesn't have all the answers, and then resisting love or feeling like things aren't moving forward. And then we have this blast of energy forward. It is, he stops resisting that sun. He comes out of the hermit state with this spiritual strength backing him up. And it's, the sun is a brand new beginning of life. It is seeing life through a child's eyes. And it is harvest, abundance coming towards you. It is payoff. Your turn to shine in the light. It is also masculine energy. Sun is masculine and feminine is the moon. So he has acquired so much spiritual knowledge and strength because we've got the hermit here who is retreated from the material world in search of his own wisdom and knowledge in order to find the light within and shine it brightly so that he can guide others out of the darkness. And here he is being represented as the sun. Pure energy, and he's moving towards the Queen of Pentacles, which is the Earth Queen. Here the Earth King is showing up in the message from Higher Self, so there's a sense, remember, that he was in a state of retreat, rest, renewal, as the King of Pentacles, and there's a sense that he wants to come out of that and make something happen in the 3D, and the feminine is being asked to surrender. So here he is coming out of that hermetism towards the feminine, the 3D queen. This also represents abundance and harvest. She sends out love and abundance, shares all that she has without any expectations. And so there's a sense that he's moving towards that open, flowering, loving, generous, grounded, beautiful goddess of love here. Okay, so yeah, there's a real grounded energy and spirituality as well. Okay, so for the message from the universe, for the masculine, you got the magician again, master manifester. So there's, again, that he's really trying to manifest something, and spirit is guiding him, helping him. He's really tapping into his crown chakra. He's aware. Beautiful. He's stepping into his power. And he's becoming psychically and intuitively connected. Four of Pentacles, the Strength card. And the Ten of Cups, beautiful, reduces to a one. So we got an 11 here. The Four of Pentacles talks about being closed off, not allowing somebody into your material world, holding on to material possessions, not wanting to share. Somebody's holding on too tight to you, or you're holding on too tight to them. So there's a release, an openness. It is, he is not only tapping into his higher consciousness, but he is, finding his spiritual strength and love and kindness and compassion from within in order to move him out of that closed off feeling. And in doing so, there's a sense that there's a completion in the future. He's working towards this Ten of Cups, which is the happily ever after. It is emotional abundance on, one level up from this nine here. But it's coming together, marriage, the happy ending. So, yeah, he's finding strength and courage in order to deal with a situation that will release him from this energy of being closed off. Okay, so for your message from the universe, why do I keep saying your? For the feminine is the solar plexus chakra. So there's a reflection of energy here, a mirroring. This is standing, coming into your power, finding strength from within, courage and determination in order to make it through. So he got the strength card, which is, again, that, finding strength and courage in order to deal with the situation, but you're using love and kindness and compassion. Okay, the Ace of Wands, Page of Wands, and Temperance card. So the Ace of Wands is that idea, that spark, that inspiration, that new beginning. It is blank slate, going forward, green light, go time, a gift from the universe. The Page of Wands is the gasoline being poured on the flame, on the fire, and it's an explosion of energy. It also represents good news coming in. And remember that we got the Knight of Wands in how you view the relationship. You want to move forward in this, fiery energy towards your goal. So there's a sense that there's a message that will come in that is a go light, go time. And there's an explosion of excitement and movement towards your highest goal, your highest destiny, the thing that you've been waiting for. And then we got Temperance card. This is integration, union on a soul level. It is a zipping together of the helix in the DNA. She represents the S sign in the yin and yang. So it is complete union of the souls. So there's a sense that, you're really stepping into power and balance, and that there's a sense that there's a new start, or communication regarding a new start is coming. It's like you're almost there kind of feeling. Just find that last little bit of strength in order to, give it that one final push. Okay, so what is the energy that's surrounding him? Suffering in silence, another nine. Again, nines represent completion. So the Nine of Swords is that staying up at night, anxiety consuming you, unable to move forward. Here we got a feminine energy, here we got a masculine energy. And remember, we had that masculine energy right beside it. So there's a sense that, from that darkness, from that prison, he emerged as the high priest. Here, the energy that's surrounding him is a feminine energy that is longing, looking out to the sun, but wanting a release, wanting to touch the sun. So nine, yeah, it's it is a release. It is nearing the completion of the cycle and freeing your mind. It's a self-imposed prison of the mind. Okay, the Five of Swords, the Page of Swords, and the Knight of Cups. Okay, so the Five of Swords is conflict and defeat. It is walking away from negative people, negative energy, fighting, arguing, having your finger, you know, somebody pointing the finger at you, telling you you're doing something wrong all the time. And that's causing the sense of restriction, you know, that self-imposed prison, inability to move forward. Then a decision is made. The Page is, you know, deciding to move forward with an idea, making plans in order to manifest it into reality. The Pages are also communicators. The feminine got the Page of Wands here, and the masculine got the Page of Cups. So communication is big in the reading. There's a sense of wanting to communicate or messages coming in soon. So the Page of Swords is a double communicator, because swords are communication, thought, expression of truth. And so not only, you know, does the Page want to speak his truth, but he is a messenger. So yeah, there's a sense that he wants to find that mental clarity, speak his truth, get rid of this negative energy, and get on his stallion, put his best armor on, and offer his love to his true love, the twin. So the Knight of Cups also represents a yearning, a longing, a wanting to offer your love. It's a poetic gesture. It isn't an actual beginning of a relationship. It is a wanting to. It is wanting a relationship to evolve. So, yeah, there's a definite sense that the feminine is waiting and suffering as a result of that waiting. Her heart is being broken. Okay, so the energy that is surrounding the feminine is the Nine of Cups. Repeated card. The masculine got that in his present position here. So another nine. Another completion. So this is wish granted. The Nine of Cups is the masculine energy, what I'm getting here, because, like I said, it's coming in from the present, his present. He feels like his dreams are coming true. He's feeling an abundance of love, and he wants to celebrate that love with you. So you are where his heart is. Nice. The High Priestess, the Five of Wands, and the Five of Cups, two fives. So again, there's a sense of heartbreak, longing, wanting, and because you have an attachment on an emotional level to your masculine, it is causing emotional heartbreak. So the Five of Wands talks about obstacles and challenges, and it isn't meant as a negative energy. It's meant to as a challenge in order to make yourself better, improve yourself, make yourself stand out. So, you know, there's a sense that this obstacle, this inability to truly manifest this happy abundance, this dream fulfilled, is causing emotional loss and this obstacle. I mean, I don't know, this seems like a major heartbreak. But here we have the Divine Feminine in her spiritual form going within and trying to clear this negative energy away from her. This, you know, this challenge, this competition, this rivalry, this trying to make yourself noticed, and releasing emotions, attachments. The two feminine energies here are both going within. It's a release and healing. Whereas in the middle, we got these two masculine energies, creating this obstacle. But here we are, the divine feminine trying to balance herself internally as well as externally. Balance. Strength, spiritual strength, balance. All right, so what is masculine fear? Ace of Pentacles, brand new beginning, 3D world. He is, this is coming together, planting that seed, that new beginning, and nurturing it and growing it, making it, healthy and, grow into this fruitful tree. Ten of Wands. So the ten reduces to one, so there's an 11 here. An ending, a completion, and a beginning. The King of Wands and the Knight of Swords. Wow. Okay, so the Ten of Wands is having burdens on your back. And there's a sense of it collapsing. It's an end to feeling burdened and, taking on too many responsibilities. Your body is giving out. You're burning the candle at both ends, and you can't keep it up much longer. Your health is being affected. Okay, so there's a huge fiery energy here. Ten is ten wands. And then we got the King of Wands, and he's the center of the sun. He is standing in his masculine energy of the sun. He's burning brightly. He's the leader. He takes charge of the situation. And he makes his destiny a reality, which is this Ace of Pentacles. He wants to have this new beginning in the 3D, but he is afraid in a sense. The Knight of Swords could represent an air sign, but it again, these are both masculine energies. It is the masculine coming in, sitting down, speaking his truth. He is the champion, the rebel without a cause, unemotionally attached, mental clarity, and it's a sudden energy comes in out of the blue. So there's a sense that he's afraid to speak his truth, to really step into his power. And he is carrying a lot of burdens, a lot of responsibility. But there's this sense of an ending coming soon, whether he likes it or not. So, and from it, the truth will be spoken eventually. He has to, because he steps into his ultimate power in the future, which is the divine masculine, true authentic life. And you got that 11-11 connection. Right, and then the Six of Pentacles, Eight of Pentacles, which is that growth coming from this Ace of Pentacles here. So although he is afraid, to move forward and come into his power, he will, ultimately. Okay, and again, we got the sun showing up in the future. Okay, so what is the feminine afraid of? Completion, again, the universe. She's afraid that that final piece will not be laid. She wants this finality, and she wants a new beginning. And universe is saying, hang in there. Seven of Pentacles, patience. Ace of Pentacles. Wow, and judgment. Okay, so Seven of Pentacles, that is waiting. The pregnant pause, waiting for that abundance, that harvest, that moment for your ship to come back. It's a reevaluation of the past in order to, you know, set yourself up for the future, but also make sure you don't make the same mistakes. It is continuous movement forward, but it is a promise of a return that the ships are coming soon. Hang in there, have patience. I know I keep repeating myself, and it feels like I'm, you know, somewhat repeating the same message over and over again, but this is not me speaking, it is universe speaking. I don't, you know, decide what the cards mean, I just read them to you. So, yes, waiting, that's what this whole purpose is. The whole purpose of the Fool's Journey is to detach yourself from the outcome and, you know, step into your consciousness, your awakening. This journey isn't about union. It is about your spiritual journey, your connection with yourself and your knowing. It is a detachment from wants and needs and conditions and expectations. Judgment card talks about your life. You're realizing that your life is this movie being projected on a screen, that it isn't reality. You choose the characters and the plots. So it's an awakening. So in order to really allow this Ace of Pentacles to be manifested, for it to come towards you, there's still waiting involved. And it is causing heartbreak. So again, us feminines need to release ourselves from the outcome. And that will open up the channel for abundance to come in. Okay, so now I am going to look at the bottom of the deck for the overall energy. Temptation, the devil. So this is being attached to things in the 3D world. And so it could represent an addiction or a codependent relationship, but it's a chain that's binding you. And realizing that you are the sheep amongst the lions. So it's a letting go of these attachments, these conditions, and finding freedom. It is awakening a higher level of consciousness. So it's a shared energy. So the sense that both the feminine and the masculine are going through this, you know, back and forth, you know, unsure of what's real and what's not. You know, the addiction to the material world and the ego, and then, you know, looking at your spirituality back and forth, it's like, which way to go? All right, so now I'm going to pull two cards. This will represent the energy that's being, you know, the message that's, or sorry, the energy that's being brought in from either aspect into the union. So for the feminine first, Three of Cups, celebration, union. So the masculine got this in his, how he views the relationship. So there's a sense of, you know, coming together and celebrating love. You are offering love. You're an open receptacle to love. I don't know, I'm having such a hard time talking all of a sudden. Okay, and for the masculine, the Knight of Swords. So speaking his truth, finding his truth, and opening himself up, not being closed off like this knight here, but it's a movement forward. Okay, and for the foundation, Nice, the King of Pentacles, abundance. So the feminine got that in message from higher self. There's a sense of healing himself in order to be open and generous, giving as well as receiving. Okay, and for the crowning energy, Ace of Swords, consciousness, spiritual understanding and knowing, a state of peace, stillness, truth. And for the heart-centered energy, I'm going to use I'm going to use the call it bear and read for the union energy, and then I'm going to pull two additional cards from call it bear and read for the message from the universe. Ooh, goblins for the feminine, heal the out, masculine, follow the leader. That is so weird. I got this same combination in the last private reading I just did. And I know that I shuffled these well. So the feminine is either needs to go through a healing process, release some pain, or be open to the giving this healing energy. Heal the out. Forgiveness is the healer of the soul. This is a time for great soothing of the heart, body, soul, mind. As this card indicates, the healing will be prevalent in your life right now. If you feel drawn to study the healing arts, you'll be successful in developing your natural capacity to restore others to wellness. The heal the ouch card may also be an indicator of old wounds and broken bonds being mended. Reconciliations are possible now. Let bygones be bygones. For the feminine or the masculine is 40. Every life is a teaching tool for others. Your authenticity and honesty are an example to those around you. You're being called to lead others by example. Your wisdom has been earned as this is on page 111. Thought I'd point that out. As a result of your bravery in the adventure of your life, the experiences of battles won and lost, places discovered, tears shed, and joy revealed have placed you in a unique position to be of service to others. Your suffering has been crystallized into the talisman of wisdom. Now you must share it. By being fully authentic, you'll lead others into the light. You'll be required to divulge some things about your past so that you may help someone else. Lead with love. There is another message here as well. Look to those whose great character and accomplishments you admire. Emulate the leaders you respect. You will in turn have more to offer. And the five is goblins. I'm not surprised to see this energy here. It's very reflective of the devil. It's like these whispers, this negative energy being whispered into your mind, into your ears, and you're listening to them. Fear is an illusion. Choose love today. Forgive yourself and others. So this is the union energy. Goblins are born when you're wounded and something essential is lost in the experience. From that point on, as you forget your wholeness, they remain with you in the shadow. There they remind you of what brought them into being by mimicking your own voice, tricking you into believing that you're unworthy, victimized, and unlovable. They hold you hostage through low self-esteem, self-sabotage, and the feeling that you're lacking what you need. If goblins pay you a visit, know that they represent the shadow of your own self or someone else, and that they are leading you into a potentially reactive situation. A goblin's card appearance is an opportunity for growth, however, and a signal that you must love yourself. No human is without flaws. The goblin's message is that you must release resentment and negative self-talk. Within you is the spark of the divine. Ask spirit to help heal you. Miracles can and do happen. Let go of the negativity. So it's an ultimate release. So I think that I will read the Ace of Swords here, representing, you know, the way through this goblin forest is through the Ace of Swords. It's, you know, coming into your truth, stillness, and quieting of the mind. Okay, we come from the unknown and we go on moving into the unknown. We will come again, and we have been there 1,000 times, and we will be there thousands of times. Our essential being is immortal, but our body, our embodiment, is mortal. Our frame is which we are, our house, the body, the mind. They are made of material things. They will get tired, they will get old, they will die. But your consciousness, for which Buddhahārma uses the word no mind, Gautama Buddha has also used the word no mind, is something beyond body and mind, something beyond everything. That no mind is eternal. It comes into expression and goes again into the unknown. This movement from unknown to known and from the known to unknown continues for eternity, unless somebody becomes enlightened. Then that is his last life. Then this flower will not come back again. This flower that has become aware of itself need not come back to life, because life is nothing but a school in which to learn. He has learned the lesson. He is now beyond delusion. He will move from the known for the first time, not into the unknown, but into the unknowable. So there's a sense that you both are coming into this higher state of consciousness, awareness, and stillness, of knowing and not knowing. Okay, so I want to read the King of Pentacles, 72, which is the foundation energy. Okay, in the East, people have condemned the body, condemned matter, called matter illusory. Maya, it does not really exist. It only appears to exist. It is made of the same stuff as dreams are made of. They deny the world, and that is the reason for the East remaining poor, sick, and starvation. Half of humanity has been accepting the inner world, but denying the outer world. The other half of humanity has been accepting the material world and denying the inner world. Both are half, and no man who is half can be content. You have to be whole, rich in the body, rich in science, rich in meditation, rich in consciousness. Only a whole person is holy person, according to me. I want Zorba and Buddha to meet together. Zorba alone is hollow. His dance has not an eternal significance. It is momentary pleasure. Soon he will be tired of it. Unless you have exhaustible sources available to you from the cosmos itself, unless you become existential, you cannot become whole. This is my contribution to humanity, the whole person. So, there's this real stepping into wholeness, oneness, completion. But you must go through the goblin forest first. A clearing. So, I'm going to do the Knight of Swords. There's a sense that the Divine Masculine is being a little closed off because of these thoughts, these goblin-y whispers in the air. Oop, wrong one. Okay. The figure in this card is completely covered in armor. Only his glare of rage is visible, and the whites of his knuckles on his clenched fist. If you look closely at the armor, you can see it's covered by covered with buttons, ready to detonate if anybody so much as brushes up against them. In the background, we see the shadowy movie that plays in this man's mind. Two figures fighting for a castle. An explosive temper or smoldering rage often masks a deep feeling of pain. We think that if we frighten people away, we can avoid being hurt even more. In fact, just the opposite is the case. By covering our old wounds with armor, we are preventing them from being healed. By lashing out at others, we keep ourselves from getting the love and nourishment we deserve and need. If this description seems to fit you, it's time to stop fighting. There's so much love available to you if you just let it in. Start by forgiving yourself. You're worth it. And I might as well read the Three of Cups. So, celebration. This is a moment to celebrate, to enjoy, make it fun, a celebration. And then you will enter the temple. The temple is not for the long-faced. It has never been for them. Look at life. Do you see sadness anywhere? Have you ever seen a tree depressed? Have you ever seen a bird anxious? Have you seen an animal neurotic? No, life is not like that. Not at all. Only man has gone wrong somewhere. And he has gone wrong somewhere because he thinks himself to be wise and very clever. Your cleverness is your disease. Don't be too wise. Always remember to stop. Don't go to the extreme. A little foolishness and a little wisdom is good. And the right combination makes you a Buddha. So don't go to the extreme. Don't overreact. Hold love in your heart and be open to giving and receiving. And that will ultimately draw your masculine out of the darkness, out of his armor and fears, and heal, help him heal, and you heal. So it looks to me like there will be a week of release, which ultimately leads to, you know, your dreams manifested, and for some, the masculine coming into the 3D with an offer. All right, so I hope you enjoyed this. If you want to contact me for a reading, my email is in the description box below. And cheers, much love, peace.